These are criminally cozy games on sale that you can play right now. And also, guys, I have this interesting game that will be at the last part of the video, as I don't know yet what to really think about it. It has a demo, so you could always check it out and tell me what you think about it. So let's start with the coziest of all, in my own opinion, Spiritfarer. So you can build a boat, explore the world, and care for your spirit friends. Spiritfarer is one of the coziest management game me and my wife has ever played. It has a two cooperative play where you play as Stella or Daffodil the cat. We really enjoyed spending a heartwarming time with our spirit passengers in this game and formed a memorable bond with them. Well, the hardest part was learning how to say goodbye to our cherished friends though. For our next game, although I haven't played this game yet, and I wanted to grab that game as soon as I can though, I checked out the Steam reviews and here's what they say. So they said it's a cute and cozy game similar to Stardew Valley and Animal Crossing, with a lovable variety of different personalities amongst the characters. Little Witch in the Woods brings you in this mysterious fantasy world. You play as Ellie and experience her daily life as an apprentice witch. Some of her daily tasks is to gather and process materials to create potions and use it to help nearby villages. I think the game loop goes that way, plus also those adorable scenes and dialogues. It will definitely be one of the coziest games you can play. So along the way, on top of that, you may also meet some cute creatures and find hidden places. Now, this next game is an icebreaker where you build and run a bed and breakfast, but you're a bear. Bear and Breakfast is a laid-back management adventure game where you play as a well-meaning bear trying to run a B&B in the woods for unsuspecting tourists. In order to build your flourishing B&B, you gotta gather some materials, meet some folks, with the goal of providing your guests the best experience in staying and resting in your place or your B&B. In return, we'll give you a review and depending on how you manage and run the B&B. As your business expands, so the mysteries of the forest. Are you bear enough to search deep within? Traverse strange new lands, learn their culture, and enlist the help of new friends along the way in this handcrafted charming adventure. Karto is wrapped around a unique world-altering puzzle mechanic designed to help you be reunited with your granny after being separated from a storm, so you could chill out and explore peaceful yet mysterious lands as you rearrange pieces of your map and watch the world change around you. People see that it is a nice game and the style of painting invokes healing and cute at the same time. The music also makes people very relaxed and the gameplay is simple yet interesting. And most of all, the plot is rich for personal feeling. Like, it will really dig you down deep into your soul, I believe, and have a good time with it. So our next game is The Wild at Heart, where you wield an ever-growing herd of quirky creatures to rebuild broken paths, battle perilous beasts, and solve peculiar puzzles in a rich and interconnected world. As you join two young runaways as they unravel the mystery of the lost realm in this nostalgic storybook fantasy. Be cautious though, malevolent beings lurk in the shadows and you may find yourself wanting to stay near campfire light until sunrise. Have you ever wanted to brew your own beer, run a farm, and build relationships with your customers to create your own fantasy tavern? Be an innkeeper and traveler's rest on a journey to transform a rundown inn into a bustling social place. So plan and manage your tavern to create specific food and drink for the people, as it will increase your tavern reputation over time to earn rewards and unlock more options to make your dream tavern. And now finally, we are in the game that I'm not sure what to think about yet, but the name of this interesting game is A World of Little Legends. I gotta be honest, I like the art style of it, and also the whole concept is a game where you can actually do farming, crafting, at the same time terraforming. Everything seems to be very perfect. However, the game is gonna throw you in this dilemma where, are you satisfied or is it okay with you to be trapped in a magical snow globe for the rest of your life? Or are you still gonna find your way out? Like, right now, I'm having a dilemma if I'm gonna try out this game or not. But since there is a demo, why not, right? You can check it out as well. and tell me what you think about it in the comments. And by the way, guys, I'm looking at this awesome video, Conceit, which I've been waiting for 4 years, and finally it will be fully released on the 6th of December this year. I made a couple of videos about it, more of the informative side. You can check out at the lower left hand corner of your screen. And if you've enjoyed watching the video, please let me know by giving it a thumbs up and subscribe. See ya!